next reaction, oxidation of alkynes. Oxidation of alkynes. Write down, alkynes on reaction with aqueous KMnO4. Alkynes on reaction with aqueous KMnO4 in neutral medium. In neutral medium forms diketone. Forms diketone. Okay. This reaction takes, don't write this, this reaction takes place in neutral as well as in basic medium also. Okay. So basic medium may will have different product. Suppose the alkyne is this, and when this is allowed to react with KMnO4. With H2O, aqueous KMnO4, medium is neutral. Right? The first step, the product is OH R dash, you form out. And then from this, H2O molecules, two H2O molecules goes out, and we end up getting C double bond O, R dash, diketone. Okay, we have, see, when the carbon has two hydroxyl group present on the same carbon, this kind of compound is not at all stable because of the presence of lone pair on these oxygen atoms. Under normal condition or slightly when you heat this, it easily goes under dehydrolysis, H2O molecules eliminates from this, okay, and it converts into C double bond, carbonyl compound. Okay, mechanism you can understand. Suppose this lone pair, see if you draw the resonating structure of this one.
So won't it be the lone oxygen forms a double bond and then becomes O plus and H plus?
This comes over here. No, it won't happen like this because conjugation is not there. See, actually what happens, this oxygen-hydrogen bond is polar because of high electronegativity of this oxygen. So this hydrogen or this hydrogen is acidic in nature. Okay? Slightly when you hit this, this H plus comes out. Okay? And this H plus kya hota yahan pe aa jata hai. This oxygen atom behaves as a base, takes that H plus from this. Right? So this H plus comes out. This becomes O minus, and we have H plus is taken up by this oxygen, so we get OH2 plus.
Sir, can you?
What I said, we have OH here and OH here. Both hydrogen atoms are acidic. H plus comes out slightly when you heat this, even at normal temperature also.
So right. I take that lone pair and
yes,
oxygen.
Yes, so this H plus is taken up by this oxygen, which has one lone pair. It becomes O positive charge after this. And finally what happens, this goes out as a leaving group, H2O molecule eliminates, and with this positive charge here, it comes back here and forms a double bond. Right? So you always remember this, whenever carbon has two hydroxy group present, then this won't be the final product of the reaction, because from this easily dehydration takes place and it converts into ketone. So with KMnO4, aqueous KMnO4 in neutral medium, you get diketone. Next, in this writer,
Sir, why are gem dihalides more stable? Doesn't the halogen over there have three lone pairs?
Three lone pair hai yahan pe, but there's no, what we say, hydrogen. Like here, see why this is not stable. This oxygen hydrogen bond is highly polar. So H plus here release kar paata hai, which is taken up by this, which is a base. But this carbon halogen bond, it is a strong bond. Right, carbon hydrogen bond is a strong bond, and there is no hydrogen attached to this halogen atom, which is not possible. Hydrogen can have only one bond, right? That's why there is no elimination of H plus here, and this bond is comparatively strong but easily dissociated when it's at normal temperature.
So, but then this is still less stable than vicinal dihalide.
Vicinal, no. See, we cannot compare the stability like this. Our vicinal hai aisa, why you are saying it's less stable?
So because over here there's
static repulsion.
Static repulsion, again, emotional link on it. Static repulsion, kaise lag gaya tumhe static
repulsion? So, but there are three lone pairs.
Three lone pair, even chlorine-chlorine bond forms. Now, to ye bhi nahi form hona chahiye. Both chlorine atom has three lone pairs. So steric hindrance hai, but it is not there. The distance is sufficient there to minimize that repulsion, or we can say it can adjust the two halogen atom here. Right, so dekhke we cannot say ki steric repulsion. Aise to problem ho jayegi. Point is, if you have aisa kuch, when you see, we have started organic chemistry, right? So when you will do two, three more chapters, you have this idea, kahan pe steric repulsion hoga nahi hoga. Jaise dekho, aur OH hai yahan pe, theek hai? Or if there is a nucleophile called CS3, CO, oh not this one, suppose we have like this, suppose this molecule is there, right? We'll discuss this later, that when this molecule is attached, and some electrophile, suppose we have, what we can say, suppose we have Br2, electrophile is bromine, okay? Now, in presence of this group, the reaction is Br2 with FeBr3. It is the bromination reaction of this compound. Derivative of benzene, this group is attached. Score dalo to benzene ho gaya. Now, when this group is attached, this current say we'll get one specific product. Because of this group, we have product here possible. Bromine can get attached either at this position or this position. Yahan pe bromine ka attachment nahi hoga. Because it is orthopara-directing group. Electron releasing group, orthopara-directing group, right? Now the point is what? Agar yahan pe we have to talk about the major product, then this is the bulky group. So ortho pair attachment kya hoga? Difficult hoga because of the repulsion. Yahan pe steric repulsion will come.
So how big is bulky?
Bulky is like dimethyl, suppose we have this kind of compound. It's a bulky base. So acyclic compound. Two things change is small and acyl carbon paper do bulky group. Possible. But we'll do that. Correct.
So we never consider halogens bulky?
No, even this is also not bulky. But what we are talking about, we'll get either ortho substituted or parasitic product. So which one is major? Jahan pe steric hindrance kam. So here it is. Understood? So bulky and steric hindrance will generally consider it aromatic compound. Aliphatic may be possible, but that is when you have carbon-carbon bond. Wahan pe hota hai ki bond rotation hota hai. Right? There are many things. If you have one group here, to minimize the repulsion, one of the bond rotates like this. Another side, etc. So we'll discuss connecting one part. Here, there is no steric repulsion. So, as you see, feel ho raha hai ki steric hindrance hai, toh wo nahi kar sakta. So feeling ko side mein rakhna hai. Okay. Right on, next. Second point in this one. When alkyne is treated with basic aqueous KMnO4, in basic medium reaction, basic aqueous KMnO4, no, this is a normal temperature. The basic medium reaction is slightly higher temperature, we call it as at elevated temperature also. So suppose the reaction is RC triple bond CR dash, and the reaction is KMnO4, basic medium KOH, and aqueous solution, and slightly we are heating this at an elevated temperature. Okay, so in this one what happens, you'll get carboxylate ion COO minus plus R dash C double bond O. It's a mechanism for complex actually. Maine kya tha ye mechanism. MnO4 minus is this, double bond minus. So similar kind of mechanism is there. Okay. But just you have to, what you have to keep in mind, if it is non-terminal alkyne, then it forms acid. Oxidation, KMnO4 is a strong oxidizing agent. Right? Why strong oxidizing agent? Because magnesium oxidation state is plus 7. Right? That's why it will go under reduction. Will oxidize others. Right? So it is a very strong oxidizing agent. So oxidation of alkynes gives you acid. Right? In acidic medium. But if the medium is basic medium mein kya hota hai? You have to just, it's very important also. Suppose you will get acid first. But since the medium is basic, so your basic medium will take this acidic H+.
Plus. So it will just exist as RCO minus?
Yes. Because this H+ plus is acidic, this H+ plus is taken up by the base and it forms carboxylate ion. So always remember this point that basic medium mein kabhi bhi acid nahi form hoga. Always we get what? Carboxylate ion. We never get acid in basic medium. Because this H+ plus is acidic taken up by the base and we'll get carboxylate ion.
So then, in acidic, will it stay as COH?
Right.
Does it happen in basic medium?
No, basic medium may happen. Acidic medium may acid form. We'll see the preparation of carboxylic acid. When we have basic medium, then we'll get ion, carboxylate ion, not acid.
So we already learned this thing, the oxidation of that.
That is an alkene, similar reaction. Alkene is similar.
So oxidation of alkenes always gives us acid.
If the medium is basic, then carboxylate ion. In acidic medium, we'll get acid here. But this reaction takes place in basic medium, not in acid. Alkene ka oxidation is there in acidic medium, they will get acid. Okay. Next reaction, ozonolysis. Write down alkynes reacts with ozone followed by hydrolysis forms carboxylic acid or a mixture of acid and carbon dioxide. So suppose when carbon dioxide forms, if you have terminal alkyne, if terminal alkyne is there, then this carbon forms CO2. So the reagent is what? O3 first, ozone, and then hydrolysis of this, which is H2. So this carbon, terminal alkyne, this carbon forms CO2, and from this part we'll get acid, which is CH3CO. If the alkyne is not terminal, CH3 C triple bond, CC2H5, with the same reagent, then we'll get only acid. CH3COOH plus C2H5, COOH. Two more reactions. We just have to memorize this. There is no mechanism for this. Write on rearrangement of alkynes. Rearrangement and polymerization. Just two more reactions. Write down. When alkyne is heated with ethanolic potassium hydroxide, the triple bond of alkyne, ethanolic potassium hydroxide, KOH, the triple bond of alkyne migrates towards the center of the chain. Okay, so reaction is, if you have CH3 CH2 C triple bond CH, KOH in ethanolic solution. Ethanolic means ethanol. Solvent is ethanol. Okay, so like I said, there is no mechanism here, just this will shift towards the center. CH3 C triple bond C CS3, this is a product.
So what if it's odd number?
Then also it will shift towards the center.
But then when we have a center, like if you have CS3, CH.
Suppose we have this. CS3, CH2, CH2, C triple bond, CH.
Yeah.
Again, shift over here. One shift is there. Just one shift.
So maximum one?
Ah, one shift will be there. Then when you have the option, you'll understand what is the possible problem. Okay. Okay. Now one more thing, if you heat this one, non-terminal alkyne with any NH2, sodamide, in presence of paraffin, then this converts into the original one, which is CH3CH2C triple bond C minus Na.
So, but how do they just, so how does KOH ethanol just put into this?
See, like I said this, that there is no mechanism here. It's just an observation. When you heat this at certain temperature, a triple bond, which means there will be some bond dissociation and bond formation. Shifting means this bond will dissociate and we'll get a more substituted alkyne.
Is it electric?
No, it's not. Electromagnetic something. Okay, so there's no mechanism of this, just two reaction you have to memorize.
So is it out of syllabus or does nobody know? Is it out of syllabus or does
nobody know? No, it is there, but it is out of the syllabus. The mechanism part is not there in the syllabus.